Carrie Engel from Valley View Farms is here to answer your plant and gardening questions. How are you?
Hello. Good, good, good.
These are the coolest plants I've ever seen.
They are cool. This is a pitcher plant, and this is a Venus flytrap. And these have little, actually, hinge leaves in it, and there's like two or three little hairs in there. If an insect gets in there and either touches both two hairs at one time or one mm-hmm. and then the other, it snaps closed.
Now, if you smell it and your nose gets too close, does it snap on your nose?
They're little guys, okay. So I don't know. They don't get too big. I mean, they will definitely, you can feel them on your finger. I've taken like a toothpick or something and put it in there.
So they really will take care of the bugs.
They really will take care of the bugs.
Okay. Let's get to some questions.
Okay.
All right. When's a good time to seed your entire lawn?
You're coming up on it. I mean, with as much moisture as we have in the soil, with the cooler temperatures this weekend, I mean, that's really ideal. If you can get out there, take some of those bare spots, or if you need to do the whole thing, put down some fertilizer, put down some grass seed, and you're good to go. I mean, if we keep getting some rain now and then, it'll keep that going, and they'll germinate in no time.
Excellent. What are the best low-maintenance shrubs to plant around your yard?
There's a lot of different ones, and it depends really on how much sun or shade you have. I use a lot of Nandina in my yard, or Heavenly Bamboo. It really will take some shade. It does need a whole lot of care. It gives me some nice fall color, and it also even gives me some winter berries, so I like that. A lot of the hollies are pretty nice around here. And azaleas and rhododendrons in the right places will do very well. If you have deer issues, there's a plant called the plum yew that I really, really like because the deer don't bother it, and it's just a nice, full, tight evergreen. So it's really nice. There are
wonderful.
A lot of good things out there.
A lot of good options there. Is it true to let the leaves stay put until spring? I hear it's beneficial to the soil and holds moisture and protects the grass.
In general, it's okay as long as you shred the leaves. If those leaves are full and on the lawn, you're going to have some dead spots just where they are, especially if we get a lot of snow and it stays wet. But if you can take the mower over a couple of times and shred it, and in your perennial garden or your annual garden, pull the leaves out, shred them, put them on back, they'll love it.
Okay, excellent. Anything else that you're hearing? I mean, it's been such a roller coaster with the weather. We had the really hot weather, our lawns got really dry, then all of a sudden a deluge of rain. So,
well, in my own yard, I know I have to do some weed control because I've seen some new weeds because we don't usually have this much moisture this late in the season.
Yeah.
The other thing, if people have lost some trees, fall is a wonderful time to plant trees, so you can really get the roots in and going and not worry about the tops of the trees so much. Planting shrubs and perennials, it's also a good time. So if you had some storm damage, take a look around the yard and see where you might be able to replace some things.
Might be able to use those trees for firewood, too.
Give them a year or so, but yeah, be careful about buying firewood this year. Make sure that wood is aged. So
okay.
We have good idea.
Enough. Thanks so much, Carrie.
Thank you.
Great to see you. And if you have a plant or gardening question, you can email as well as send pictures of your plant or garden to plantquestions@WBALTV.com or go to our website, WBALTV.com, and click on Family. You can also send your question and pictures to Plant Questions, WBAL TV, 3800 Hooper Avenue, Baltimore, Maryland, 21211.